Graffiti Jam Galleries, and I am here with Gemma Lynch Memory for her second solo with us, and we are very excited about this new body of work. Your Fleur exhibition, which was the last exhibition that we had, it's a real departure from the R&B series with what we have now. So it's like a full circle, because we know you've done the R&Bs and the other landscapes before. It's great to see this new series of works back in the gallery. Can you elaborate on how the R&Bs differ from the previous series, but visually as well as conceptually?
Absolutely. I'd probably say that in preference to the Fleur exhibition being a departure from the R&Bs, it's probably the other way around. I think for me, the Fleur exhibition, that was the departure. That was something that after painting R&Bs for so long, I went off on this little tangent with the florals. I'd done the Wildflowers quite a bit,
yep.
But the Fleur exhibition was more of a structured kind of a floral thing, and that for me was something that was really different.
Okay.
I'm back in my comfort zone here. In the country, and I grew up going to an uncle's property, and everything that you see in my paintings, all of the fence lines and the water holes, and he had the most amazing roadside mailbox, and I was fascinated by it as a child. And I used to get out of the car when Dad used to drive across the grates to stop the cattle from getting out, and study and just to be enraptured with this roadside mailbox. We had a suburban one, which was really boring.
Yep.
So everything about my landscape paintings is a direct drawback to my childhood. A lot of my girlfriends have fetishes for handbags and shoes.
You do mailboxes.
I have a fetish for roadside mailboxes. And so it's nothing for me to be driving along with my family in the car and stop the car. There's another one. Fantastic. I've got to photograph it. So I'm very passionate about
them. So many people who get out there have put so much time and effort, you know, and you look at the bits and pieces that are being part of an old Milton or whatever.
That's right.
But, and some are so clever, do you know what I mean? So,
and they all have their own personalities, and their personalities are very, very much an extension of their owners.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you've told me about Terry putting the Vegemite toast underneath the thing, because you lock yourself away for hours and hours.
Yes.
Is that still happening?
I do.
Still Vegemite on toast?
Yeah, he knows. Vegemite toast does it for me every time. Absolutely, yes. No, if I'm on a roll and I'm working on something and it's a glaze, I just can't stop. Well, you'd know that being a painter. You just can't stop. It's not something you can stop halfway through and come back to.
Because you've got that whole build up.
And some of these mediums, to the contrary, they will dry really quickly. So the bottom of my paintings, I have to see it through till it's finished. And sometimes, you know, I'll stand there for so long just getting it right. And you know yourself when it's right. And when it's right, okay, I can stand back from that now and go on it, that Vegemite toast that is stuck under the door for me.
So
the artwork here tonight. What did you think?
Yeah, no, I really like it. I love it, especially the one over there with the horse and the lady on the horse. I think it's great. I love it.
The use of colour is really good. Very impressed. I'd like to be able to buy all of the paintings here.
The energy of the way the painting sits and the four panels and the way that I divide all it's almost a bit of a spiritual thing, that whole, the horizon line where the heaven meets the earth.
Yes.
And that middle body, and that's where the conversation happens, in that kind of that middle panel. But the under panel is very, you know, it's the very calming, it's the underground, it's the very grounding sense of the painting.
Yeah.
And often I'll look back to earlier works, I didn't quite get that right in that painting, but I feel like that for me is something that I'll push it here now until I get it right, and I feel I get that little Virgo coming out and going, okay, that feels right.
But that's exciting too.
But that's challenges that I feel like I've overcome, you know, over, you know, many years of just, you know, trying to get the same thing right.
Because those lines, those divisions, that land line, horizon line, they are, to me, I just look at a paint and just can see, you know, with those, it is so your handwriting. It's just something that I haven't seen before that this is and what you've developed. And the way they sit out is incredible. You know, the way you can pare back, but there's almost a roughness, you know, that's there, and then there's beautiful flat areas, and then you've got the texture.
That's the landscape, isn't it? Yes. That is exactly what happens in the landscape.
Contrast.
Absolutely.
Contrast
there is
colour,
those,
texture.
Yes, those beautiful rough parts, but then something else is so smooth and so, and together it culminates to be balance.
Yeah,
and I think
exactly.
That's where I'm kind of looking to, what I'm looking to achieve is that balance within my paintings, that the landscape, you know, it does naturally.
Well, I just want to thank you again for being here. We have got people coming through, which is so exciting.
Lovely. And hey, thank you. I love this gallery. I love being part of it, and I love,
So we just want to thank Gemma, and it's going to be a great night.